This interest rate report brought to you by Macquarie Bank.
The members of the Reserve Bank Board met for the first time this year on Tuesday, the 2nd of February, and after considering December and January's economic data, kept the official interest rate on hold at 2%. Despite recent financial market ructions over concerns on global growth, the RBA would have drawn on this data to ascertain if growth is at risk. By all indications, this is not the case, and Macquarie forecasts global growth at 2.8% for 2016 and 17. Domestically, the December employment release showed stable unemployment at 5.8% and strong jobs growth over the last quarter of 2015, justifying the RBA's decision. Third quarter GDP of 2.5% surprised and may adjust modestly down on weaker commodity prices, which impacts Australia's national income and ultimately filters down to household income and spending. The lower Australian dollar and weaker oil prices weighed on fourth quarter inflation, which at 1.7% was in line with expectations, but remains below the RBA's preferred range of 2-3%. The US growth outlook is on solid ground. 290,000 new jobs were created in December. Wages are growing, residential construction has some way to go, consumer spending is holding up, and the service sectors are doing particularly well. While Eurozone growth is unspectacular, the European Central Bank continues to add stimulatory measures, and Macquarie forecasts growth this year of 1.5%, again driven by the weak euro and service sector demand. The main concern for financial markets has been the imminent collapse of China's growth. Macquarie does not prescribe to this view. The latest official GDP release show the Chinese economy growing at 6.9%. China's been transitioning away from investment in infrastructure as the main driver of growth. Consumption is now half of the total economy and growing at about 10% as a larger number of households have been urbanised and increasing their prosperity. As service sectors globally are doing well, I thought it would be interesting to show you the chart of a leading indicator, a survey of the services Purchasing Managers Index, which shows future activity in sectors such as healthcare, education and tourism, amongst others. A reading above 50 shows services expanding and below 50 contracting. The US and Europe are growing well. Despite large economies such as Brazil and Russia, which are in recession, emerging markets are still expanding. The depreciating Australian dollar has been assisting our economies rebalancing, with improving growth from our own service sectors, which are typically export orientated. The stable employment data and mixed US dollar outlook may infer our currency's depreciation has come to an end. Macquarie is of the view that rate cuts in May and August may be needed to keep this process on track. The next RBA board meeting will be held on Tuesday, the 1st of March.